journey started, we went to say goodbye to him because he wasn't supposed to make it. If there was going to be a funeral, I had already written what I was going to say. And 120 days later, he made it.
Yeah.
Oh, I've been waiting for this day.
I was so happy to just be home. It had been so long, although I don't remember a lot of it.
Well, he ended up with pneumonia, COVID-related pneumonia, and he ended up in the ICU at Ajax Pickering and intubated. And then they had to send him to Oshawa because at that point his kidneys failed and he needed dialysis. So they moved him to there, and the doctor in the ICU said, you better come say goodbye because he's not going to make it.
I felt bad that, you know, she had to go through that. It's something that no one should have to do for their loved ones.
You know, thankfully the medical staff didn't give up on him. They worked on him. They, you know, were so grateful for that, what they've done for him.
Home hemodialysis is basically what you are having in center now, but doing it at home.
Then he went to Whitby, Lake Ridge Whitby, where he finished off there with the rehab and dialysis, and he still goes there for dialysis now. May 7th, when he came home, was actually the date of our first date, 49 years ago. That made it even a little more special that he was coming home.
You know, every day is just a blessing. I have, you know, another day. And, you know, hopefully a lot more days to come.